A very good morning, my dear students. So today we are going to start the chapter that is hydrocarbons, and it is second part of organic chapter. Like you can say, that second chapter of organic chemistry. And today I'm here with the lecture number one. So in previous chapter we have done all the reaction mechanism, and here we will learn certain family, okay, like alkane, alkene and alkynes reactions, what are the reactions, and few mechanism will also be there. So that how whatever you have learned in the mechanism way, that will help me, is going to help me over here. Okay, so let's start the video as usual with the quote, and the quote is, do it now, sometimes later becomes never. So it's self-explanatory, like the things, whatever though you have decided, whatever you think to do, just do it right now, because kabhi kabhi aisa hota hai ki baad mein kar lenge wo kabhi nahi aata. Like hindi mein kehte hai na, kal kabhi, kab kal tumhara kab aayega, so kal kabhi nahi hota. So it's like that. Okay, chaliye, let's start. So introduction of hydrocarbons, as I have already told you in the previous chapter only, that hydrocarbons, there are the two things, one is organic compound and another is hydrocarbon. So any compound in which carbon is there, that will be called organic compound. Okay, and if the organic compound is just made up of carbon and hydrogen only, then it will be called hydrocarbon. This is combination of two word, hydro and carbon, that means hydrogen and carbon. Okay, so hydrocarbons are the binary compound, that means only two atom will be there of carbon and hydrogen only. Hydrocarbons occur in nature in the form of coal, natural gas and petroleum. All the organic compounds other than hydrocarbon are derived from hydrocarbons by substituting hydrogen with a functional group or by adding a functional group. Like jitne bhi organic compounds hote hain unme how they will be prepared, how they will like obtained. So whatever the hydrocarbons jo bhi hote hain, unke jo hydrogen hote hain, that is substituted by any functional group or any group, any other group, then only the organic compound forms. Yes. So next is classification of hydrocarbons. Like hydrocarbons are basically how many types of class hydrocarbons are there, that we are going to understand. So hydrocarbons are classified into two categories. One is aliphatic hydrocarbon. Aliphatic hydrocarbon, that means open chain, that or you can say that two or more than two terminals. Okay, and second one is cyclic hydrocarbon, which will have no terminals. There will be no terminal. Yes, here we will first study aliphatic type, which are further divided into saturated hydrocarbon, alkanes and unsaturated hydrocarbon, alkenes and alkynes, which we have done in class 10th also. Alkanes are also known as paraffins because they are less reactive. Yes, so that's why they are also known as paraffins, while alkenes ko hum olefins kehte hain. Why? Because the first member of this is the tendency to form the oil, so that's why. And the cyclic hydrocarbon, which are further divided into cycloalkanes and aromatic hydrocarbons. So here is the flow chart. Like this is hydrocarbon is divided into acyclic or open chain, which is like there is no terminal, there will be more than two or more than two terminals. And the cyclic, that means there is no terminal, it will be in the ring form. Acyclic is divided into two parts, saturated hydrocarbon, which is also known as alkanes or paraffins, and they have carbon-carbon single bond. Unsaturated is having it is of two part, one is of alkene and another is a alkyne. Yes, so alkene and alkyne, it is having triple bond and it is having double bond over here. So and the first member of alkene is also known as olefins. Okay, aromatic hydrocarbon, which will be which will follow the Huckel's rule. There should be a ring and follow Huckel's rule. And next is conjugation may be hona chahiye. This is alicyclic, this is acyclic, there is no ring over there, but alicyclic, that means there will be ring over there and but not aromatic. So like we can say cyclohexane, cyclobutane, cyclopropane, like this. Yes, so first we are going to do in details, and that is alkanes. So alkanes have general formula CnH2n plus 2. that is the CnH2n+2 general formula, and they form homologous series also. We have already studied about the homologous series, what they are, that members, two consecutive members, if there is a difference of CH2 group between two consecutive members of any family, then it is called alkanes. Yeah, that homologous series. Yes, alkanes. So these have tetrahedral structure around carbon atom, or we can say that all carbon in alkane show sp3 hybridization. Like they have carbon single bond carbon, so obviously the valency are satisfied by hydrogen single bond only, so we can say that sp3 hybridized. So all carbon in the alkanes are sp3 hybridized only. The important members of alkanes are methane, ethane, propane, butane, and its isomers, which we will already have done in previous chapter, but little bit more we will understand in this chapter also. Generally, alkanes are represented as RH, RCH3, RR, R dash. What does it mean? Like if there is R alkyl group and the hydrogen can be attached, and instead of this hydrogen, if any other group like CH3 is there, this may be a different number of carbon. Yes. And if RR, that means it is going to attach, like whatever the number of carbon is, like next slide we will do about the inverse reaction and all that. So example is like this CH3Cl plus Na. Let me explain this thing. So what will happen, this Cl 2Na and this Cl will come out as a 2NaCl. So what left, CH3 and CH3, so they make a bond. So in this case it is also considered as RR bond. That means both are having same number of carbon. If it will be RR dash, that means it is not having same number of carbon. Another example, let me do with this. If I am doing this CH3Cl, 2Na and C2H5Cl. So this can give CH3C2H5. So here total number carbon is C3H8. That means in this case we will say RR dash. Got it? Clear? So where R and R dash are alkyl radicals. So this is the all representation. This is structural formula of methane. Yes, this is its geometry or shape. You can say that tetrahedral, and this one is the 3D structure. How it is? This bond is out of plane. Next is preparation of alkanes. That means what are the ways by which we can get the alkanes? So there are various methods. Out of that, few methods we are going to learn. Yes, the first method is reduction of alkenes and alkynes, that is also known as hydrogenation, and this we have done in class 10th also. I hope you can remember this. Yes, hydrogenation, that means addition of hydrogen. So this reaction is, hydrogen is actually gas, so it needs some metal to absorb it. So we always do this reaction in presence of a catalyst, that is nickel, platinum or palladium. Out of these three, we can use any catalyst. Okay, so this is CnH2n, H2 ke presence mein, like with H2 in Ni ke presence mein, it will give you alkane. So this is alkene over here, and let me give one example like C2H4, or we can write like this CH2 double bond CH2. This is H2 and this Ni I can use, or PT I can use, or PD I can use, and the temperature will be 573 Kelvin. So what will happen, this H2, 1H with this, 1H with this, it will be. So there is a mechanism, actually this will follow the homolytic cleavage, homolytic breaking of bond, there will be. So all the mechanism I'm not going to explain, and even you don't know, there is no need to learn that. Few mechanism are important according to class 11, so that I will tell you that particularly reactions you have to understand with the mechanism. Yes, so just for a common knowledge, I'm just telling you that homolytic fission will be there. Yes, if what it will follow, which intermediate will be followed in this, will form in this, so that is free radical intermediate will form. Next is alkyne. This is CnH2n-2 alkyne, and when this react, it can also give alkane. So this reaction occurs in like two step. Suppose that this is alkyne. Yes, we can say that ethyne. So what will happen when this H2 reacts in presence of Ni or Pt or Pd, it gives CH2 double bond CH2. Here it becomes ethene. And this followed by the same reaction, then it gives CH3, CH3. Yes. So here it will give ethane. Or we can get in this, we can get directly. So there what we'll do, I will add this H2 and H2, and directly I can write 2H2. In presence of catalyst, Ni, Pt, Pd, you can use. The most important thing is that here, this is known as Sabbat-Ettrier Sanderson reaction. And for this reduction, for the reduction of alkenes and alkynes, PDC carbon ethanol, this is also known as palladized carbon in ethanol. Okay, so this can also be considered. It's used as 25 degrees Celsius and 50 atm pressure. That is generally used. Okay. Now the next thing is, this is the equation again. CH3 whole twice. This is CH3C. I can write like this. CH3. Here it is 3. It is yes, C double bond CH2. When it undergoes hydrogenation, 1H with this, 1H with this, and it will form CH3CH CH3 CH2, single bond CH3. Yes, so this is also called 2-methyl butane, or you can say that isopentane. It should not be isobutane, sorry, it will be isopentane. Yes, clear. Next is from alkyl halide. Alkyl halide is represented by like this is R, alkyl and halide. That means instead of hydrogen, there is X. Okay. So this is called alkyl halide. So by reducing alkyl halide also, we can get alkanes. We are learning about the preparation of alkanes. So how, what are the ways by which we can get alkanes, that I'm going to explain. Yes. So here it is. Next is by reducing alkyl halide, and that is reducing agent, we have to use that zinc in presence of acetic acid, or Zn in presence of HCl, or Zn in presence of NaOH, ZnCu couple, also like it is also called zinc copper couple. Yes. Next is amalgam, aluminium mercury amalgam. This can be used. Okay. So basically, jo most importantly use hote hain, wo ye hota hai, Zn plus HCl. Okay. This also used zinc copper. Rx plus H2, if you do that, what will happen? This H, 1H with X will go to HX, and this R alkane will be prepared. But this reaction is not simply, if you will not mention anything over here, this is not possible. Got it? So, ye yahan pe yaad rakhna hoga ki we have to write the reagent over here. Any of the reagent you can write, any of the above reagent you can write. But simply if you write Rx plus H2 change into Rh plus HX, this is not possible. Okay? Alkyl iodides are reduced by HI in presence of red P under high temperature and pressure also. Like we can write that instead of chlorine or bromine, if it is RI. Okay. So we can use this red P in presence of HI, and this will give you RH plus I2. Like RI plus HI. So red P, and then R halide, and this alkane, and then iodine. Iodine can be removed by phosphorus as 2P plus 3I2 change into 2PI3. Iodine jata kaha hai, ye kaise remove hota? So by this reaction I have written over here, this P plays a role, and this reaction this reacts with iodine and forms a 2PI3, aur ye remove ho jata. Otherwise this reaction will be reversible. Ye wapas se ye reaction de dega. So we have to do red P in presence of 150 degrees Celsius high pressure. Wurtz reaction is the next reaction, and that is going to be a most important reaction for this class, class 11th. Okay? It involves the condensation of two molecules of alkyl halide with sodium and dry ether to have symmetrical, to give symmetrical alkanes. Alkyl halides always in like 2 moles we have to take, 2 Rx. Yes, in presence of sodium, and that is dry ether we have to use. So this will give you R and R. Whatever the symmetrical alkene, dhyan rakhenge, symmetrical alkenes, okay, and then it will give you 2 NaX. Like this, 2 Ri plus Na, dry ether. Ye dry ether ke presence mein hona bahut zaruri hai. This is sodium in presence of dry ether is also an important point, okay. दिस रिएक्शन इज ऑल्सो नोन एज ऑल्सो यूज एज स्टेप अप रिएक्शन. स्टेप अप का मतलब होता है वी कैन इंक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन बाई वन. ओके सो और बाई द सेम नंबर ऑफ कार्बन विद which is already present in the alkyl halide. Like another, like if we can take an example, let me take the example. Like I am taking CH3Cl 2 moles. Okay. So what will happen, instead of writing this 2 moles like this, I will write 2 and this is, I will write like this. Can I write CH3Cl 2? So this will come out as a 2 NaCl and CH3 will be attached and will give you like a compound which is having more number of carbon than the previous one. जितने थे उसके उससे ज्यादा और जितने मतलब थे उतने ही डबल होंगे. डबल नंबर ऑफ कार्बन बेसिकली इट गिव्स अ कंपाउंड हैविंग डबल नंबर ऑफ कार्बन. नोट, मिथेन कैन नॉट बी फॉर्म्ड बाय दिस मेथड. ये याद रखेंगे. इसमें फर्स्ट थिंग तो ये चीज है, इफ वी स्टार्ट विद आर डैश आई एंड आर आई वी गेट अ मिक्सचर ऑफ एल्केन्स एंड इट इज नॉट गुड मेथड फॉर अनसिमेट्रिकल एल्केन्स. व्हाट इज इट इज like we can write here, suppose that CH3Cl and I'm using C2H5Cl and I'm using then in presence of dry ether. Okay, so what will happen in presence of dry ether, this compound will be doubled and it will give you CH3, isn't it? Plus this will also doubled and it will give you C2H5, and then one of combination of this, so it will give you CH3C2H5, isn't it? So instead of getting only this, I will get this and this. तो इन तीनों का जो mixture मिलेगा, जिसकी वजह से इनकी isolation जो होती है वो काफी difficult हो जाती है. We will not be able to isolate these compounds, and that's the reason that this method is not good method for unsymmetrical alkanes. So question can be asked that why in Wood's reaction unsymmetrical is not, why Wood's reaction is not good method for preparation of unsymmetrical alkanes. So this is the only reason. Got it? Methane cannot be formed by this method because is method mein hamesha carbon double hota hai aur methane mein single carbon hai, so we cannot get a methane as a product, isn't it? Yes. ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ एल्काइल हैलाइड जो भी होगी वो आर आई के सबसे ज्यादा होगी बिकॉज ऑफ बॉन्ड लेंथ. आयोडीन का साइज बहुत बड़ा होता है एंड लाइक देर विल बी बिग बॉन्ड लेंथ ओवर देयर, सो बॉन्ड डिसोसिएशन एन्थैल्पी विल बी लेस, इजंट इट? एंड लाइक दिस आर आई आर बी आर आर सी एल आर एफ. ठीक है, Franklin reaction, what is this? Franklin reaction is also important reaction but not so important as Wood's reaction. In this case, instead of Na, we will use Zn. That is the only difference, and rest same, everything is same. Okay, this will also be done in presence of dry ether. Don't forget to write it over here. What is the difference between Franklin and Wood's? Wood's reaction in presence of sodium, in presence of sodium, and Franklin reaction, that means in presence of zinc. Got it? That is the only difference. Rest everything is same. Next is reduction of alcohol. Alcohol ke reduction se bhi hum alkene mil sakta hame. We can get it. How? ROH plus 2HI red P. Be very careful. In that case also, RI ke case mein bhi agar hum HI aur 1 red P use kar rahe the, there also we were getting alkene and here also we were getting it. So that is, there is no difference. बट दोनों में ध्यान रखना, वहां पे क्या था, एल्काइल हैलाइड से भी मिल सकता है, लाइक एल्काइल आयोडाइड होना मस्ट है, इट कैन नॉट बी एनी अदर हैलाइड. यस, एंड अल्कोहल से भी हमें बाय द सेम रिएजेंट, बाय द सेम कैटलिस्ट वी कैन गेट इट. नेक्स्ट इज रिडक्शन ऑफ एल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन्स. दिस ऑल्सो गिव्स द एल्केन. एल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन्स, क्लेमेंसन रिडक्शन एंड वुल्फ-किशनर रिडक्शन, दैट वी विल डू इन डिटेल इन क्लास 12th. Here you have to learn few things that I'm going to tell you. Aldehyde is RCHO. Like it is clear, alkane ka 1H is removed by CHO group, so this becomes aldehyde. When this aldehyde undergoes reduction in presence of zinc amalgam, in presence of HCl, acidified amalgamated zinc, then it will give you alkane. ठीक है, ये कंप्लीट रिड्यूस हो जाता है. नंबर ऑफ कार्बन विल बी रिमेन सेम. यहाँ देखो आर और सी, यहाँ पे भी आर प्लस सी, नंबर ऑफ कार्बन इज सेम. हेयर ऑल्सो दिस इज कीटोन, कीटोन के साथ भी वही कर सकते हैं हम, सेम चीज सेम रिएजेंट एंड इट विल गिव यू आर सी एच टू आर प्लस एच टू ओ. सो इफ वी आर यूजिंग अमलगमेटेड जिंक इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ एच सी एल इट विल कॉल्ड क्लेमेंजन रिडक्शन. ओके एंड वुल्फ क्रिश्नर रिडक्शन जो होता है वो बेसिक मीडियम में होता है. सो वेन एल्डिहाइड रिएक्ट्स विद दिस इज कॉल्ड हाइड्राजिन, हाइड्राजिन. ओके सो हाइड्राजिन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ बेस इट विल गिव यू आर सी एस थ्री, अगेन द सेम थिंग. सो दैट इज नॉट सो इम्पॉर्टेंट, इसको आप नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, आई एम राइटिंग फॉर क्लास 11th, इट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, वी विल डू इट इन क्लास 12th. यस. फ्रॉम कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड ऑल्सो वी कैन गेट, फर्स्ट मेथड इज रिडक्शन, आर सी ओ एच प्लस सिक्स एच आई रेड पी, वही सेम चीज सिक्स एच आई पी रेड पी यूज करेंगे तो इट विल गिव यू एल्केन, बट नंबर ऑफ कार्बन विल बी रिमेन सेम. ये इस बात का ध्यान रखेंगे, नंबर ऑफ कार्बन शुड नॉट चेंज. यहाँ देखो आर प्लस सी, हियर ऑल्सो आर प्लस सी. यस. डी कार्बोक्सिलेशन इज अनदर रिएक्शन. डी कार्बोक्सिलेशन, कार्बोक्सिलेशन का मतलब होता है सी ओ टू एंड डी का मतलब रिमूवल. सो रिमूवल ऑफ सी ओ टू इज कॉल्ड डी कार्बोक्सिलेशन. सो बाय विच वी कैन गेट द एल्केन. बट यहाँ पे क्या होगा, ऑब्वियसली देखो रिमूवल ऑफ सी ओ टू मतलब एक कार्बन कम होगा. सो दिस इज यूज एज स्टेप डाउन रिएक्शन. दैट मीन्स वेयर वी विल गेट द कंपाउंड विच इज हैविंग वन लेस कार्बन दैन द reactant. Yes, it is obtained by heating sodium salts of carboxylic acid with soda lime. NaOH and CO ke presence mein, that is soda lime, it is called soda lime. Yes, so in this case removal of carbon dioxide will be there and it will give you alkene with one less number of carbon. So we can see that here R plus C, but here only R, isn't it, one carbon is less. So it will give what it is, NaO, and this will go out to give Na2CO3 and this H will attach to this. This CaO just plays a role to dissolve this. Okay, otherwise it will not it will not consume in the reaction. It will not be consumed in the reaction. Clear? So this is decarboxylation. This is important reaction for your class 11th. Any doubt in this, bachche? Note, in the product there is one carbon less than parent carbon, parent compound. So, this reaction is an important method to reduce one carbon atom in organic synthesis known as step down method. Why I am explaining all this step down and the step up? There is a conversion. Generally, teachers and students both, they do conversion in class 12th. So, it will be like little tough for you, but I will start conversion in class 11th also. In class 11th only, so that it will make you that will enhance your learning strength. Yes, and your reaction, your organic chemistry will be good in way. So if you are I'm just telling you that conversion is not a topic that I can explain. Conversion is just a command on your organic chemistry. If you have organic chemistry concept clear hai, if you have command, you can do the conversion. Aur agar vice versa we can say, agar aap conversion kar pa rahe ho, that means aapko sare reactions yaad ho gaye. Yes, so just keep the things in mind. We have done Wood's reaction as a step up, we have done decarboxylation reaction as a step down. Yes. Next is Kolbe's electrolysis. This is also very, very important for class 11th, and mechanism will also be asked for this Kolbe electrolysis. So in this case, when sodium salt of any acid undergoes electrolysis, okay, so it gives alkane at anode and hydrogen gas at cathode. Okay, this reaction is not called as द सेम थिंग. वहां पे भी हमने सोडियम सॉल्ट यूज किया था, यहाँ पे भी सोडियम सॉल्ट यूज करेंगे. द ओनली डिफरेंस इज दैट कि वहां पे हमने सोडा लाइम यूज किया था और यहाँ पे हमने सिंपली व्हाट वी से इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस यूज करेंगे. इन दैट केस डीकार्बोक्सिलेशन में व्हाट वाज दैट, इट वाज स्टेप डाउन रिएक्शन. बट इन दिस कॉल्बे इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस नंबर ऑफ कार्बन विल रिमेन सेम एज इन द रिएक्टेंट. ठीक है, we do, I'm not talking about moles, I'm just talking about in the compound. You can see CH3COONa, how many carbon, one carbon and two carbon, and here also one carbon and two carbon, so number of carbon will remain same. Clear? So let's do the mechanism for this reaction, how it is. In this case, so what will happen, the CH3COO and A will undergo electrolysis and will split into ions, that is CH3COO minus plus and A plus. Yes, and same, since it is in the solution, so water will also dissociate into H plus and OH minus. 2 moles are there, so let me write 2 moles over here, 2 moles. So for this also I will take 2 moles. Yes, any doubt in this bachche? Now what will happen at anode? Because electrolysis hai, so obviously there will be 2 electrode and there will be 2 different reactions also. So at anode what will happen? At anode loss of electrons occurs, and loss of electron kaun karega, jisne already excess electron le rakha hai. So it is having negative charge, that means it has taken electron extra, so that what it will do, this will lose the electron. So what will happen, this 2CH3COO minus will lose 2 electron to give 2CH3COO plus 2 electron. Yes, and that is unstable. So in next step what it will give, like let me explain like this, CH3COO. Okay, so this is unstable, 2 moles I am writing. So what will happen, this bond will break. Yes, homolytic cleavage. So one electron will be here and one electron will be here, isn't it? If this bond breaks, one electron, so this one electron will go to this to give you CO2, 2 moles of CO2 will be there, and it will leave 2CH3 free radical, carbon free radical. Did you get that, beta? Then what will happen, these 2 free radicals will combine together to give an alkene. Okay, so this is the reaction for anode. Okay, at cathode what will happen, cathode per electron gain hoga, you know. So kaun gain karega, jisne electron de rakha, jiske paas electron kam hai. So this 2H plus will gain these 2 electrons, is 2 electron ko wo gain karega, and it will convert into H2 at cathode. In solution kya reh jayega, jo 2Na plus and 2OH minus will left out be to get 2NaOH. So this mechanism will be asked in your paper, and you have to be very much careful about this. That's, you should know how it has done. Yes. Next is from Grignard reagent, and Grignard reagent is, I have already explained to you. This is RX alkyl halide. This is called Grignard reagent. Yes. Alkyl magnesium halide. This is alkyl magnesium halide. It is called Grignard reagent. Jahan R kuch bhi ho sakta hai, any straight chain, branch, aromatic, any ho sakta hai, wo any R ho sakta hai. Like we can say what we say, alkyl group, aryl group, it can be. And Mg will be sure, for sure. X can be BrCl. Theek hai? So how it forms, when alkyl halide reacts with magnesium in presence of dry ether, it gives this. Isi ki jagah pe agar humne sodium use kiya hota to kya deta ye? This would be Wood's reaction, and it will be RnR, isn't it? RR, that means alkane with the double number of carbon. But if it will do with the in presence of magnesium, it will give you Grignard reagent. When this Grignard reagent reacts with alcohol, so it will give you the, what you have to think, what you have to like concentrate over here for what? So this is when Grignard reagent reacts with alcohol. So whatever the number of carbon is present in the Grignard reagent, that alkane will be formed. This is R, isn't it? This is R. Here also we are getting R. We are not getting this R dash. Are you getting it, bachche? As for example, agar maine yahan use kiya CH3MgBr, and this is going to react with the C2H5OH. So what will be the product? This will give you CH, one carbon, na, to CH4. And saath mein side product will be Mg. This is Br and this is OC2H5. Clear? Like this, ye wala part, side product. Any doubt in this? Same with the case of amine also, R dash amine. What is the whatever number of alkyl, number of carbon over here, that doesn't matter. ये इससे ही जितने Grignard reaction में होंगे वही alkene बनेगा. Clear बच्चे? Water के साथ करेंगे अगर हम, so that's why it will give you, then it will give you alkene. Now एक question आता है कि why we should do that this reaction in presence of triether? What will happen if I will do in presence of water? So since magnesium when reacts in presence of dry ether, it is giving Grignard reaction, isn't it? But यही reaction अगर हम in presence in like in water कर देंगे, तो instead of getting this RMGX, we will get alkene. Is it clear? So if we will do this reaction in aqueous medium, instead of getting Grignard reagent, we will get alkene. ठीक है, that's why this reaction should always be done in presence of dry ether. Now, if I am using this any alkyne group, then also it will give you H, which is having same number of carbon as Grignard reagent. This part is not so important, not important for class 11th. Okay, class 12th में ये सारे reactions repeat होंगे. We have to do all this type of reactions. Any compound having acidic H atoms decomposes Grignard reagent. क्योंकि किसी भी compound में ये सारे H acidic हैं. Okay, so what will happen अगर यही चीज़ यहाँ पे कि अगर हम acidic like we can say that acidic hydrogen अगर होगा तो that will decompose Grignard reagent and it will give you the compound like this. Alkane and this Grignard reagent, this side product. Any problem in this picture? So that's it for today class. I hope you got it whatever I have explained. And next up is physical properties of alkanes. So that we will do in our next video. Till then, thank you class.